host you're looking for.
Mr. Juniata, I am your host. From a galaxy far, far away, we bring you Mr. Juniata 2019!
Jedi judges, Penny Hooper Conway,
I'm a wanted man in 12 galaxies.
Thank you. popular and talented, some may say, out of this world, Professor Jared LeGru of the Communications Department.
I'm thrilled to share the stage with your Dean of Students and Vice President for Student Life, Matthew Damschroeder.
I just got a DNA test. Turns out I'm 100% your dean.
That's a teacher in me.
All right, Penny, so that's how it's going to be. Well, the truth is, we couldn't be happier to welcome you to the Rosenberger Auditorium and the Mr. Juniata competition stage.
Tonight, one of your 8 class representatives will walk away with the title of Mr. Juniata and all the privileges that it entails.
Like a crown and a sash.
And bragging rights for life.
And the chance to judge next year's competition.
Unlimited jokes from Oak. Oak, can you give us one for Mr. Junior?
Who won the Miss Skellen beauty contest? Nobody.
Well, here's how tonight will work. Our competition unfolds in 3 rounds. Each of our contestants will first showcase a unique and impressive talent. Our judges will be looking for and rating the guys on confidence, personality, and skill.
In the second round of competition, each Mr. Juniata contestant will accompany a special guest as they put their charm and gentility on display. Contestants earn style points for their fashion sensibility, and creativity comes into play as their guests receive a personal and meaningful gift from their own Mr. Juniata.
Scores from the first 2 rounds will be taken into account, and a top tier of 3 contestants will be propelled into the stratosphere for a solar flare question and answer round. With little preparation, our contestants will be asked to respond with diplomacy, grace, and humor. After all, this is a diplomatic mission.
If this is a diplomatic mission, where is the ambassador? It's time to find our Mr. Juniata. Let's see how well they've learned the ways of the Force. Try as they will.
Try? Mr. Juniata is better than that. As Master Yoda taught us, do or do not, there is no try.
So be it, Jedi. Your first challenger for Mr. Juniata is first year Jack Teal. If you're trying to guess Chadwick's planet, it's Neptune, because he likes blue. On a date, Chad would take you to dinner at Dorcia in New York. You'd get the sea urchin ceviche. For you foodies, that's uni ceviche. Sounds otherworldly, right? Post ceviche, Chad would fly you to Fiji in his private spaceship, Interstellar. But if you're wondering why Chadwick is single, it's because he cannot share. He is a taker of knowledge and a giver of wisdom, and he loves his long legs. Chad spends the majority of his time thinking about the song Happy. And if you're his type of alien, he'll introduce you to his mom. Give it up for Chadwick Teal!
Hi, Chadwick. I'm giving a monologue. All my friends, they seem to call me a poser, and I don't see it, but this was our conversation the other day. I don't know why people think I'm a poser. I just sit well. When you look at me, I have good posture. See? I'm not a poser. I don't pose. I just sit well. Maybe, maybe. I stand well, too. See that? I can't do anything about it. Tom designed, literally. My friends think that I'm unnatural and that my stillness is fake. It's not true. This is who I am. When you look at me, I'm just perfect. But I still don't know why they call me a poser. I don't get it, but... I don't know, Jared. Fear is the path to the dark side. Fear leads to anger. Anger leads to hate. Hate leads to suffering.
Thank the stars, that performance was fearless and maybe astounding. Show some support for Chadwick today.
Your next Mr. Juniata contestant is third year Theo Weinberger. Theo says he will visit your planet as long as it's not Jupiter, because he's not taking any chances on getting more stupider. Stupider. He'll count the stars with you and would like to name one big twinkle twinkle. His dream date would be heading up the Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk to go surfing and watch the fireworks. You may just be his lucky date for this romantic outing if you can teach him how to surf. His dream travel would be visiting Area 51 in order to learn the moonwalk from an actual alien. And if the Force is with us tonight, I think we're about to see some of his moves.
I'm running through.
Because his secret passion is singing and dancing to Mamma Mia in the shower. Thomas's real secret talent, though, is that he can eat an entire rotisserie chicken. All of it, at once. He loves chicken so much, his ultimate heist would be stealing the secret Chick-fil-A recipe. In his spare time, Thomas dreams of visiting Saturn and marveling at its many rings.
Yeah!
Let's see if he can strike the right notes with this performance. Give it up for Thomas!
Thank you.
Was that an audition for the Cantina Band?
I'm not sure, but it might become the Emperor Palpatine's new groove.
An incredible performance. Let's make some noise for Thomas Cope.
We're going to welcome senior Evan McMullen. Evan McMullen may just be our resident Luke Skywalker, a master of fixing things, an incredible speedster. You might catch him going to Tashi Station to pick up some power converters. He's a member of the cross-country team and might even tattoo the JC Running Man somewhere on his body. If Evan discovered a star, he would name it Patrick. But Evan's already found his lucky star, and her name is Kayla.
I wrote that for you, Evan, you're welcome.
If there were no rules for one day and Evan could be as outrageous as possible, he would make a sandwich with his own two hands. I sense a disturbance in the Force, and we may witness that outrageousness right now. Here's Evan. Doing a game called Helping Hands, where Evan will not be able to use his hands, and Savannah will provide her hands for him. Who's hungry? Evan is playing the role of a volatile, short-armed Italian sandwich shop owner, teaching his apprentice the tricks of the trade.
It's the fire alarm going off again. Let me start with the sandwich. First we off, we get the little bit of the lettuce. We put it on.
Next we got some cold cuts. We got the ham. Oh, the ham. That's a lot of ham. Okay, you put it on. Let me ask you. Are you a rolled meat man, or do you just slap it on that sandwich? Don't answer that question. Next is the cheese. Oh, the cheese. Oh. No time for that. Oh, I've got the cheese. Sorry for the person that is not behind me. Next, we add a little bit of mustard. To the right. Yeah, I say to myself. Just a little bit. Oh, just a little bit more. Oh, yes, yes. Just a little bit more. A little bit. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. Next, we put this little bit of bread on the top. There we go, we said. You want a little taste over there?
How about it, Matt? You want a little taste?
I guess. I usually like a little bit more mustard, but, you know, I'll do it anyways.
Why don't you try it first, Evan? Would you like some water?
A little bit of water now.
A little bit forward. Do you right.
Not the mustard.
Oh. I guess a little bit of olive oil will wash down my arm. Oh, yes. I shake it up. No. Nothing wash. No. We had no little bit of olive oil. Wash down the arm real well. I go a little longer.
Okay. Thank you.
Evan, you should really be sent to the space mines at Kessel for that.
Even I wouldn't eat that sandwich.
Really?
Mustard allergy. Otherwise, it looked good. Well, put your hands together for Evan McMullen.
Our next contestant is Pablo Murillo, a senior. The thing Pablo likes best about himself is his willingness to be there for people when they need his help. His approach to life is to have fun and to take things less seriously, and he happily lives the single life because he loves the game. If Pablo were to meet an alien, the first thing he would show them would be East Houses on a Saturday night. If you encounter Pablo in East, be careful, as he reports that he has a severe allergic reaction to tequila, which makes him break out in bouts of spontaneous nudity. If you make it as far as a date with Pablo, he indicates he may take you to an amusement park as a relationship test, noting that if they can't handle the rides, they definitely can't handle him. I just hope we can all handle the incredible show of talent that Pablo will be serving up as he competes for the title of Mr. Juniata 2019. Hold on to your tauntauns and prepare for Pablo Murillo to sweep you off your feet.
No one puts a baby in the corner. Let's dance, beautiful.
Yeah.
really puts Pablo in a corner. Come on, Juniata, if you just had the time of your life, show some support for Pablo Murillo.
Next up is Ryan Hughes. Ryan hails from South Township, New Jersey, but resides in Terrace. Ryan would title the movie of his life, Gingerbread Man.
Gingerbread Man. Gingerbread Man.
He points out his optimism and his work ethic as qualities that he is proud of, but he's not averse to showing off his calves. If Ryan were blasting off on a mission to Mars, he would take a marimba, a baseball bat, and a picture of his family. In the crowd tonight and visiting Juniata for the very first time is Danielle, who has planted her flag on Ryan's heart. I'm sorry to be the one to tell you, Danielle, but Ryan describes his ideal date as April 25th, mostly because the temperatures are moderate and the most you need is a light jacket. I'm not sure how that portends for the rest of your visit, but good luck. We're glad to have you here and excited to see Ryan perform his talent in pursuit of the title of Mr. Juniata 2019. Please welcome Ryan.
Authenticity embodied in his favorite pickup line. Are you my student loans? Because you've got my interest, and I'll be indebted to you for the rest of my life. If you encounter this line and respond positively, you might end up on an ideal date, which Caden describes as getting to know each other better and falling in love, maybe with a nice meal, eating the rich. That's right, a romance embodied by casual cannibalistic class warfare. So romantic. On behalf of Humans at First Contact, Caden would share Avatar The Last Airbender in its entirety with our alien visitors, noting that, after being exposed to the greatest media ever to grace our Earth, no hope would remain if they killed us after that. I'm sure you can agree that Caden is uniquely qualified as such a statesman, perhaps even as Mr. Juniata 2019. Please welcome Caden back to the competition stage!
I love you all as well. I also really love being carried. Thank you, Ariel. It reminds me of Ariel. It reminds me of being carried around when I was little and when I was a teen and still now that I'm an adult. I haven't really grown, in case you haven't noticed. I would love to return the favor. You know, I'm pretty easy for people to carry around. I think I'm a bit of a confidence booster. But I can't really carry other people around too easily. If it's not evidence, why? Oh yeah, look at those. Those bad boys. I sure can't carry people around. I'm sorry. But you know what I can do? I can let people down. Yeah! I'm a disappointment. Hello, Mr. Juniata. My name is Caden Zellers, and I am one of your junior class representatives. Now, I feel that the bar has dropped a little bit for me to be here. I am 5'2". So, it's a little hard for me to cross over any bars, especially because the only reason I can claim I'm 5'2" is because my doctor mismeasured me one time. I've claimed it as my real height since. And as far as it matters to all of you, I am 5'2". So, now, I support lowering the bar as a short person. And also as a college student, I think we all love a good curve on an exam. Beautiful. I also love dropping the bar when it's a wooden bar and it has a blade at the end. Yeah, you know, wooden bar, blade at the end, necks of the rich. I love the guillotine and I hope you do too. Because you sure better. You won't like me. It's one of my two personality traits, liking the guillotine, and you gotta get to know me better before you find out the other one. In case you have not noticed, I just put not a lot of time into this script here, really threw it together really fast. It's a mess, like the rest of my life. It's fine, but I thought it was better this way, because I really believe that this is the Juniata way. It would be wrong for me to have prepared better. Woo! We love this moment because it's a disaster, but goddamn it, it's our disaster. We love it. This is my home. And I plan on burning here for a long time. So, I did not really prepare as much as I should have, as I said. I also didn't do my homework beforehand, which is gonna be real fun tomorrow. But that's a Sunday problem! Woo! Sundays are for homework and for crying! determine what type of crying it is. You see, I have three selections of tears that I choose from. We have stress tears. Those are our favorite. I do those a lot. Goes well with anything. Truly a beauty. We got our happy tears over here. They're a rarity. Super unlikely. And then we got the sad tears. Also pretty common, especially after I talk to my parents. But you guys can help me determine which of these tears I mix together for tomorrow. I'm kidding. I'm not going to guilt you into doing anything. That is for your parents to do. Especially my parents. It's bonus points if they guilt you when you bring up how they guilt you. That's the ultimate parent move. I'm letting you know. That's being a parent. Oh boy. So, we don't have a lot of time together tonight. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. So, we gotta make every little bit count. Especially because under capitalism, every single second is supposed to be profitable and productive, including this show. I just wanna take a nap. God damn. So what that means is I can't just come up here and do my mediocre comedy routine in front of you all. I have to be a multitasker. I have to think about while I'm up here how we're contributing to a good cause, how I'm being a visible member of the trans community, how every time you guys pretend to laugh at one of my jokes, my sad little self-esteem gets up a little. Of guillotining the rich, it becomes a little more acceptable, and we get a little closer to guillotine o'clock. Because you know what happens after guillotine o'clock? I gotta take a nap. I wanna take a nap. So, yes, now, I hope that you are in agreement with me about wanting things to change. I kind of like just came up here with the assumption that you did. Assuming is bad, I know, but I've only done this thing twice, so can you blame me? And both of those times, it was at the Prism drag shows, and yeah, you should all go to those. Next semester, we have another one. I should advertise this because as the treasurer, I want you to give us more money. Co-treasurer. At least until we abolish money. So, but if you haven't been there, which some of you have not, I've looked at the ticket sales, then what we have to do, I haven't given you my lesson or my remedial lesson as my drag persona, which is Hia Ting Zangin. It is poorly pronounced Turkish for, it relates to one of my personality traits. Guillotine the rich! Oh yeah, all right, yeah, I told you right. I don't have a lot of depth here. Two personality traits, very flat character, I'm telling you. So, but you haven't gotten those lessons, but I'm not Guillotine Zangin. I am just Kaden tonight, and that's even more disappointing for my mother, I think. But that's okay, because you know who still believes in me? Yeah. Uncle Iroh still believes in me! Yeah. Uncle Iroh believes in us all! I love Uncle Iroh, and I know that he'd be proud of me, even if my mother isn't. Yes. Oh, thank you. I also love you, but yeah, so anyways, a lot of things are the same though, I'm telling you, whether I'm in drag or I'm not, whether I'm performing here, I'm performing there, whether I'm Kaden or someone else, there are some consistencies. I'm always short. I'm always not as prepared as I should be. I'm always queer. I'm always just a tad bit to the left politically. A little hop to the left. And I'm also really disappointed in the quality of Baker oranges. I just want some good citrus in my life. A good orange should be big and firm and juicy. Big, firm, and juicy. Like an orange. I just really want some good oranges. And I'm telling you, the Baker oranges, they remind me of corpses sometimes. They're the corpses of the rich. They're flat, they're squishy, they're green, and we put way too much money into them. So, yeah, as I was saying, I believe you guys also want change. I hope so. Because a lot of the things going on right now, I think, are a pretty solid bummerator for a lot of us. There's some marginalization that's been going on, that continues to go on. Sometimes it gets worse. Always a fun time. There's growing student debt. My student debt watches me sleep at night. It's actually my roommate, if you look in Eagle's Nook. For this semester, it is by far the scariest roommate I've had. And sadly, I don't think I can get a room change. And the planet is kind of, as we know it, dying a wee bit. And some people don't want to do anything about it. It's a fun time. It's a really fun time. So I'm hoping that you guys also want change because of these things. I'm assuming, of course, I think that we all want change in policy, in attitudes, in discussions, in the options of fruits and cafeterias, especially the citrus fruits. I also think we all really want a nap. And until it's guillotine o'clock, I have to conserve all my energy to make every second productive. So I'm gonna leave this stage like I came on, not walking. Ariel! Thank you all. You're all beautiful people, and I plan on loving the revolution with you.
If you're ready to join Caden's revolution, let's hear your support. Nuggets at East a little later.
How about a $10 Sheetz gift card?
Yeah, a $10 Sheetz gift card. gift card might be worth it. Do we have any Wookiees out there that want to step up and share their warble? Where are my Wookiees? I need two Wookiees. Come on up. Come on up. Grab another Wookiee. I need so many Wookiees. I see back there. Back there. Yeah, come on. Come on, we need your warble. One more, over here. Oh, Taylor. You've been nominated. Come on, bring that beautiful warble up front. All right, fourth contestant, hurry down. Hurry down. All right, Jared, would you give us the classic warble? The standard? That was excellent. I think you're getting better. All right, we've got four contestants. Let's step up here a little bit. Is that okay? Into the light, step into the light. All right, we're gonna ask for your name, your POE.
My name is Andre Johnson, and I study environmental science.
I'm Fair Phillips, and I'm general science education.
Excellent, welcome.
My name is Taylor Hollibook, and I'm preemptively embarrassed.
We love that.
My name is JP, I study international studies.
All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get a warble, and then we're gonna get audience feedback. It is you now in the voter's seat, America, Juniata. So we're gonna get a start right here with Andre. You ready to go?
Yeah.
The bar has been set. I'm impressed. We can start a language floor in the global village.
I can't make this noise without any voice behind it, but I can move the...
Wow. I feel like that embodied the anger that was at the core of some of the rage issues that we saw in Chewbacca. Thank you, Taylor. All right, we're going to vote. So who among you has love for this Wookiee warble? And a truly unique warble, number four.
Taylor got the audience vote there, but...
Congratulations, Taylor! Pretty embarrassed, and yet still the winner. Pretty amazing, I have to say.
I need to sign up for lessons with Wookiee number two. I thought you were the star there. I'm just
going
to take this off, too.
Well, I'm excited to introduce our final talent, Gabe Miasano. Student from Japan, Genki is most comfortable when he has a guitar in hand and a crowd in front of him. Genki's best performances might be those times when he trots out his favorite pickup line, "I can write you a love song that nobody else can write." Packing for a mission to Mars, Genki will be sure to take underwear, a toothbrush, and a nose hair trimmer. He aspires to live a long, full life and then to quote, die peacefully in his sleep like his grandfather, not screaming and yelling like the passengers in grandfather's car. We are delighted to welcome Genki to the Mr. Juniata 2019 stage to share his talent tonight. Give it up for Genki, my
okay, good evening, guys. Are you ready for a bit of music? So just let me make sure before I actually start it. So every single sound I'm gonna be playing is a sound I'm making right now, and I'm gonna be making those sound phrases loop with this lovely machine called Loop Station. So, you know, I just wanna make sure that no extra players are hidden behind the stage, okay? Also, like, I really appreciate your, you know, clapping or like singing along with me together. But like, if you scream too much, sometimes it's gonna be kind of hard for me to, you know, listen to my own sound. So could you possibly like listen to my performance with like, you know, decent level of screaming? Does that make sense? Like, you know, with like relatively quieter one. Okay, is that fine with you all? Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. Thank you.
feel like the bag and I feel like the plate. We talk for hours and hours about a sweetness and sorry, how your family is doing okay. Leaving, getting a taxi, kissing the backseat, turn and drive and make the radio play. Cause I'm singing like you, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead. I may be crazy, don't mind me. Say, boy, let's not talk too much. Grab all my waist and put that body on me. Come on now, follow my lead. Come on now, follow my lead. I'm in love with the shape of you. Push and pull like a magnet too. Although my heart is falling too, I'm in love with your body. Now let's let you in my room. Now my bedsheets smell like you. Every day discovering something brand new. I'm in love with your body.
I think we should channel the force.
Let's do it.
Bring out your cell phones now!
I think if you look in your class Facebook group, you will find a link to a Google voting form where you can voice your opinion and vote for your fan favorite.
Do it now. Your class Facebook group. And if you don't use Facebook, you should get the link from someone else.
What do you think, Gold Five?
These guys are going to have to stabilize their rear deflectors and watch for fellow contestants.
They will have to stay on target. Stay on target.
We're so close.
They're coming in and they're bringing their guests.
Gold Five to Red Leader, incoming.
Stay on course.
Incoming. Incoming.
So it's time for the style round.
The style round. Let's hear it.
It's that time when we get to see a little galactic swagger in action.
For our second round, we'll see how these space hunks show off their dapper, classy, and timeless style as they introduce the Leia to their Luke.
You mean the Chewbacca to their Han?
No, the 3PO to their R2?
No, the, you know, the BB-8 to their Poe.
No, it's P-O-E, Program of Emphasis.
No, it's not. More like Edgar Allan.
Be still, my telltale heart. I've been looking for companionship in all the wrong places. Yet, it's about to emerge here as our contestants bring out their guests. Are we ready? That didn't sound very ready. Are we ready? All right, first up is Chadwick and his guest. Chadwick is escorting Sasha Guzman. Sasha's POE is, quote, confused. Their relationship is rooted in an undying love for sheets.
Hi, everybody. This is my perfect friend, Sasha. Being the perfect boy, you need a perfect escort. So, for you, I got your flowers. Because you're beautiful, and everyone deserves flowers. And this is for later, for the 3 pounds on my back, and give me a massage.
Theo is accompanying Finnegan Cook Huffman, who is supervised by a very cautious and responsible Grace Cook Huffman. And their relationship was described as good friends.
So for my lovely escorts, I definitely brought up some nice gifts. First, for my homie Grace, this is a gift for you. I'll open it for everyone. So because Grace is so sweet and decided to come back from her frisbee tournament and do this just for me, I got her a little snack. Wanna read the card?
It says, you're a snack, so you deserve to have one from Mr. Juniata.
Just saying.
What is it?
You want to open the gift for Megan?
First-year foundations class. How's that signature essay coming along, Eric?
Alright, so this is Eric, obviously. He's on the cross-country team with me. We have a great time running around all over the place. So I heard from a bird that you like home decor. So I got you a set of Christmas lights for your room. That's it.
Next up is Evan, accompanying Carl Sanko, a Juniata alumni.
Hey, boo. I know you're probably a little nervous out here.
I'm on the stage, so I'm petrified.
So, what I got for you is my gift of being uncomfortable on the stage with you. We are gonna take one of the 5 hottest peppers in peanut form, right here, right now. Don't worry, I got some milk and ice cream. Are you ready?
Let's do it.
See if you first, though.
Matt, do you know CPR? Before we get started, is there a doctor in the house and not a PhD?
Thank you.
Now we wait.
Put the spoof scale.
The highest. The one I took was 13 million Scoville Kepas in Christmas.
Attending Alfie Eagle, born in 1876, and a major in environmental science.
So Alfie, we met like 2 years ago in the football stadium, and we've been part of the cheerleader team, and it's been an honor to be working with you, so I asked the cheerleaders for the picture, and they thankfully like sign it for you, and I frame it for you, and I hope this will be a good memory over 2 years. And I know it gets sometimes really hot in there, sweaty, smelly. No, I'm kidding. I love you. But also, there's also times where you get hungry. I heard like you took some nachos and cheese one time in the game. So, and I also heard you like to eat worms. But I couldn't find any real worms around here. So I got you gummy worms. So when you get hungry, and I hope you like them. And I'm gonna miss you, Alfie.
Ryan is escorting Danielle Barber, who studies education at Rutgers University, New Brunswick. Danielle is Ryan's girlfriend. So, as most of you know by now, Danielle's my girlfriend, and I'm really lucky to have her. And she really loves art. She's the paint to my palette, and she's the and she's the Bob to my Ross. So I figured I would get a simple but effective gift that I thought would be useful for her. So I got her 3 things. I got her, I don't know how to say it. Naturally made coloring utensils. She really likes pins, so now you know that. So we got her a turtle pin and a seal pin. Thank you.
with guest Katie Jarvis, a social work and Spanish POE from Churches.
I would like to thank you for helping me with Spanish homework. So I do good in Spanish at Henry. So I would like to thank you for letting me borrow your calculator when mine stopped working. And I'd also like to thank you for being a great friend. Being friends with you and the rest of the friends in our group has truly been one of the best things. I was terrified that I would not find friends when I came to college, and I found the best fucking friends in the whole damn world. I love you guys so much. So, I did a drawing of this all at prom. It's in color. It's with Sharpie. I want to thank you so much for being my friend. The friends I have, I couldn't ask for better friends in the world. I love you guys so much.
And finally, we have Genki, who brings Nina Fujikawa Souza.
Okay, so, I'll just sound check it. This is kind of like a personal story, but like, I actually made up like a band with Nina and a couple other Japanese friends last year on Japanese Dinner. And since then, like, we've had a chance to, you know, perform at events like various kinds of dinners and Juniata's Got Talent, and also like Multicultural Story Festival as well. So, it was also through working in the band that I and Nina kind of became closer, and I've seen and been inspired by your beautiful voice and your musical talents that handle it. So what I came up with for this corner tonight is, Nina, why don't we sing a song together? Right? So like, because like, I couldn't find any physical thing that I can give her to, you know, to convey the outpourings of all of my honest feelings to her. So like, because she's always been helping me, and she's always been, you know, a significant person with me for this 1 year. So like, I just realized that tonight, instead of having the rest of our band members though, I thought it would also be wonderful and, you know, like memorable for us too to make this Mission Juniata stage the very first event that we even sing a song together with just the two of us. Would you like, Nina? Would it be possible for us to sing it together? Okay, so yeah, I honestly reckon that this is the best gift I can give her tonight. Because it's a beautiful night, we're looking for something dumb to do. Hey baby, I think I wanna marry you. Is it the look in your eyes, or is it this dancing juice? I think I wanna marry you.
this little chapel on the boulevard, we can go. No one will know. Come on, girl. Who cares if we trash? Got a pocket full of cash, we can blow. Shout self-control. And it's on, girl. Don't say no. If you're ready, like I'm ready, 'cause it's a beautiful night, we're looking for something dumb to do. Come on, Nina. Hey baby, I think I wanna marry you.
Let's go, Nina.
Thank you.
about that. Well, Jared, I, you know, think we should take a moment and reflect on sort of the uniqueness of the place that we live here, Huntington, Pennsylvania. And there's an interesting space connection. I don't know if everyone knows, but I would like to share that, you know, our own Huntington fiberglass factory made all of the spacesuits that astronauts wore during the Apollo missions. Did you know that? All of those made liberal arts. That's what that story
is. All right, you're starting to ramble. If that's not one of your main points, you need to just let it be.
What?
That was one of the most boring parts of the show. We're supposed to host the show, not destroy it.
What are you talking about?
I teach public speaking.
If we don't know our history, we're doomed to repeat it.
Is that a challenge?
I can't believe you're doing this. I mean, in front of everyone. I mean, if you want to get into it, let's get into it. But Star Wars style.
Still in the running for Mr. Juniata 2019, we'd like to take a moment to thank our Juniata kick line for producing this event. With special leadership from Rachel Campitel, Savannah Mellish, and Jackie Scott.
Running our lights and sound, led by Jesse and Chris and the theater crew. Give it up for them. You know, Juniata College do exist. The force has been with them tonight. Tonight's entertainment is also in support of a good cause.
Right, the kick line is searching out a charity that will help with mental health awareness and suicide prevention.
And thanks to you and your support, we've already raised over $1,000 to that end.
Alright, I think it's time to announce our top three contestants. Are you ready?
I'm so nervous, and I'm glad that I'm not a judge.
Alright, while we're at it, we may as well thank our great judges as well. Let's give them a round of applause. Alright, our contestants in no order are...
still being determined. Because all of our contestants are still in the running for Mr. Juniata 2019.
So, now what?
Let's do another battle.
Okay.
Can we get a little smoke?
I think we should demo the next audience contest we're about to do.
Okay. I'll take that challenge. You know, I've been telling Jared for quite a while that the Force runs strongly in me. And frankly, I am sometimes able to do things like deflect Nerf bullets with a plastic lightsaber. Yeah, I'm good at it. I practice at home.
We might just have another $10 Sheets gift card on the line for anyone out there who thinks that they can replicate math skills or best hand.
Lightsaber Nerf Force Deflection. You will go first, my Pet One learner. Your goal is to deflect as many of the 5 Nerf bullets that will be sent your way. Alright, do you think she can do it? How many out of 5 do you think she's going to get?
5.
5 out of 5? That's some fun. See, that's Juniata, right? That's Juniata! Alright, we're going to do it from right here. You're going to get 3 in a row. Deflect as many as you can, alright? Oh! Close your eyes. Reach out with the Force.
Okay,
I think we might need a force deflection. Lightsaber off. You wouldn't see that kind of talent at Susquehanna, I'll tell you that much. All right, we are narrowing down the field to our top three contestants
in just two more minutes.
These decisions are hard. So difficult. You know, I have to say, I was amazed by the talent. I am a person with very few artistic or kind of hobby talents. Jared, do you have any particular talents that you bring to the table?
I kind of want to take some lessons from Genki. I thought that was pretty impressive.
Kind of as I reflected on that, I thought he might pop the question right here tonight.
That song wasn't the question?
Was it? I don't know.
I think it was just a hint.
I've got to say, it would have made it one of those amazing YouTube proposal videos.
Next year, it could be you. Be careful.
Get ready, Juniata. Mr. Juniata could be that moment in your life.
Can we get the cantina music back on? Is that possible? I think we should have a house dance off. If we could raise the lights here. Everybody get out of your seats, do a little stretch. It's time to get it on to the cantina dance.
Genki! stage if your name was not called.
So, each of our three finalists will be asked to respond to questions in the solar flare question and answer round. No order has been chosen, so let's have the contestants rock, paper, scissors for order.
Jared, it's Mr. Juniata Star of the Universe. Maybe we should use rock, paper, scissors, lizard, Spock?
What?
You know, rock crushes lizard, Spock crushes scissors.
Scissors decapitates lizard. Paper disproves Spock.
Spock vaporizes rock. Lizard poisons Spock.
Okay, I think I got it.
You got it, guys?
You ready?
You got it, guys?
We're doomed.
Okay, fine. No rock, paper, lizard, scissors, Spock.
Back to basics.
Pablo, year one, Genki, two, Theo, three.
Contestants will now answer the first question. This question was given to them just 24 hours ago, and each will answer in their turn. The first question is, what is the first question? What is the first question?
Pablo, what was...
This is a memory test. You've had 12 hours.
Buenas noches. The first question was, if you could create another universe, how would it be and why would it be?
Sorry. If you could create an alternate universe, how would it be and why would it be? That's the question. Pablo.
Thank you. So, when I was thinking about this, I was thinking about how about bringing memories to, if I will be able to create an alternative universe, I was thinking, what if I bring memories to Juniata? So we have karaoke night every single night. And then I was thinking about it. When I came here, I was 13, and it was rough for me because of language barriers. So I was thinking about maybe an alternative universe without having language barriers. Like, as a kid, I was shy, but now, little by little, I was going stronger and stronger, learning the language and getting out of my bubble. So I will say an alternative universe would be without like language barriers, like you all say more.
Contestant two, thank you. If you could create an alternate universe, how would it be and what would it be?
Okay, so, this is definitely a tough question, but like, I would say I would create a universe in which every place is filled with music and people are communicating with each other through, you know, through singing, dancing, or like whatever they feel comfortable. So this would be like a, you know, like a scene from like a musical show, right? So I mean, in my opinion, music is one of the most powerful and you know, liberal forms of self-expression. So like, as it is often said that music is a universal language, I think music can make humans communication and mutual understanding possible, even with the people with you know, even with the people from totally different, you know, backgrounds for or like cultures, right? So like, like, for example, like talking about my personal experience, being an international student, I've always like, you know, I have sometimes struggled with like communicating with people around, right? So like, especially when I first came here, it was really, you know, so tough for me to, you know, keep using English, and I tried to communicate with people around using English because that's not my first language. And also like it was so hard for me to, you know, keep trying to make myself understood using second language. But like what helped me then was, you know, my experience of being a musician. So just like I did on the stage tonight, like every time I perform on the stage, perform in front of people, I always see many people's, you know, happy faces, and also like I always see many people like moving their bodies, like dancing, singing along with me, and clapping to the rhythm. That's awesome, right? That's a communication, right? And that's really beautiful of you to see. So like I always feel like every single person in the audience is feeling my heart through my through listening to my singing or like playing. So music always keeps me alive, and I believe that music can keep every single person alive by connecting each individual. Okay, so I believe in that power of music. So that's why I my ideal universe would be the one that's full of music.
Contestant number three, Theo. Same question. If you could create an alternate universe, what would it be, and how would it be?
So I actually thought about this question a lot. And really, I like our universe. For the most part, it has its kinks and wrinkles, but that's fine, Earth is Earth, it's cool. But there is one thing that like bugs me, and it's interesting because this Mr. Juniata, what we're raising money for, mental health, and I'm sure a lot of you guys know, is a big issue in America. We all have had the tragedy of what happened earlier in the semester, and I just wish that those events could be avoided. I know what it feels like to lose someone close to you. And honestly, if I had to make another universe, I would make a universe in which it's okay to talk to people, where people don't feel trapped, like they don't have somewhere to go to or someone that they can't talk to. I'd make a universe in which people feel free to express who they are and don't feel trapped by the social pressures of our society, all the pressure that school, work, extracurriculars put upon them, that they have someone to go to talk to and the resources that they need to do, that they need to have to thrive. Thank you.
Thank you, contestants, for those thoughtful answers.
All right. For our second question in this round, the contestants will draw a mystery paper out of this hat, and that is the question they will answer. We'll do the honors.
Please draw a question out of the hat. You get to draw it, I get to read it. All right, contestant Theo. What are the three wishes you would wish on a shooting star?
First, I would wish for more wishes because why three? No, I'm just kidding, I'm kidding. My first wish would definitely be for a 4-pack. I've always wanted a 4-pack. And I've worked so hard for it all my life, and it still eludes me. Second wish, I would definitely want to wish for a job that's meaningful in the future. I really want to do meaningful work, something that I can go to bed every night and say, wow, I can look back at my day and I really actually helped someone. I helped someone else, and I help myself in doing that. And third, I would wish that my brother was back here with us, because I miss him so much. And I don't go a day without thinking about him. So.
All right, thank you. We'll draw questions in the hat. I will read it.
Genki, why are you a good candidate for Mr. Juniata?
Okay. Why am I good for Mr. Juniata? That's definitely a tough one, but... So, first of all, I just want to say I really appreciate that I was being able to be here on the stage tonight. It was really, you know, it was really wonderful show, and it was one of the biggest pleasures since I came here. You know, to become part of this event, Mr. Juniata, today. And the reason why I was able to get in as a participant for this Mr. Juniata 2019 would be, I think that's because of my natural passion and enthusiasm for entertaining people. I think this is one of my biggest, you know, characteristics by nature. But like, you know, I've always been that guy since my early childhood. I've always been that guy who who feels really happy when I could make someone, you know, someone smile, or someone laugh, or like someone else happy too. So like, so that's why I, you know, try to acquire like various kinds of accomplishments since my early childhood, including like, you know, magic tricks, or like dancing, or like singing and playing instruments as well, like I did tonight. And I think that for the most part of my life, to love to entertain people, to love to make people happy, has been a significant role of me to, to challenge something, or like to step into the new world. So like, I'm now here in America, and you know, I graduated in Japan, but I came here in America to pursue my undergraduate study. But, and, you know, I'm still having much difficulty in, like, surviving in this environment using my second language. But I just decided that I will never stop challenging in the, you know, entirely new environment. Because I believe that I have a really strong skills by which I can make people happy, and by which I can entertain people. So I believe that to love to make people happy would be the reason I was able to get in. I was able to stand on the stage tonight. Yeah, thank you very much.
Pablo, this hat is literally overflowing with one more question. Please pull it out of the hat. I will read it. I have one job, Pablo. Pablo, looking back, what would you tell your 16-year-old self?
What will I tell my 16-year-old self? We can start by saying that from high school, you can see from, like, honestly, from being in high school to college, you just start, like, growing as a person. And me being 16 years old, especially when I transitioned from Ecuador to the United States, I was 13 and I was in middle school, and then at 16, I transferred to New Jersey, where everything was in English, and everything was, for me, was hard because I would start being shy. And then something that I would tell my 16-year-old is like, hey, hard things come through, but like, you have to push through it. You will meet friends that they will push you harder, family will be there for you. And then you just
tell you that everything's gonna be fine, everything's gonna be okay with people surround you, people around being next to you. Honestly, being also, you can see yourself being changing. Like, as many of you, as of my friends, you guys know me my freshman year, my fall semester, how I was, and then you just have to like go and grow as a person. And that's something I will say to my 16-year-old, hey, push yourself harder, you have friends there for you, be there for them no matter what, you have family, and be mature and always be happy and be positive no matter what. Keep your head up, be always positive and push yourself harder no matter what and keep it going. And then if you need to see someone who needs help, be there for them no matter what. That's what I would tell my 16-year-old. Thank you.
Contestants, you've given us much to think about and created a very difficult decision for our judges. We now invite our contestants to depart the competition stage and our judges to deliberate. Judges, please be quick.
Let's hear it for our final three top contestants.
So we're still looking for our champion in terms of rock, paper, scissors, lizard, Spock. If we can get the music and the house lights back up, it's your turn to stand up and challenge the people next to you to see if you can make sense of this great game.
And showing up tonight. It means a lot to us because we put a lot of hard work and hours into this event, and to see it all come together and have a good turnout is just very meaningful for us. So can I get a drum roll? All right, you guys, be ready. that will be going towards charity, thanks to you guys. So give yourselves a round of applause. Right. Who's ready to hear the winners?
All right, are you ready for the big reveal, Juniata? We have a number of awards to announce before we announce our winner, Mr. Juniata 2019. First, we have our fan favorite. That's right, many of you cast votes for fan favorite in the Google poll that was posted in class Facebook groups. And we have the results. The results are in. Jared, who will be named 2019's fan favorite? Yankee! Where that sash with pride. We also have Mr. Popular. Our contestant who was named Mr. Popular raised the greatest amount of funds based on their popularity and participation in the contest. And we are proud that Mr. Popular is standing on the stage with us here tonight. Trying to be a good Tyra Banks. Jared, who is our Mr. Popular 2019?
Let's hear for Chadwick!
The contestants worked long and hard together to create this performance, and each of them was asked to vote for the other contestant who they felt embodied the spirit and values of Mr. Juniata. And our contestants did vote for one another. And the person that they collectively decided was Mr. Congeniality is...
Ryan!
Congratulations, Ryan. And so we are ever closer to naming Mr. Juniata 2019. And we will first name the runner-up for Mr. Juniata 2019, who is... Congratulations, Theo! And that means that the contestant who is still in the running for Mr. Juniata 2019 is... Genki!
Until the next episode, that's our show for tonight, and on behalf of Mr. Juniata,